Experimentation now may be difficult, so I had to talk with Tiasa that day. So I told that maybe some simulations you can run for the time being, and if at all possible, maybe experimentation will do later. So I want to tell you about a website which is open source, free to use. It's nanohub.org. So if you log into NanoHub, maybe you have to log in through either Gmail or Facebook, or you have to make a separate account in the NanoHub. I have logged in through my Gmail account, so you also can do that. And once you log into NanoHub, on the top right corner, you will find this menu. You have to click on the menu, and then resources, you have to go to tools. So if you click on tools, a page will open which will list all the tools. There are a lot of tools in this, maybe more than 200-300 tools. So many tools are there. So the tool which we'll be using, that is S4, called as S4, Stratified Structure Solver. So everything on the left hand side, it is alphabetical, so you can just drag it down, and at the starting we'll find S4. I'll try to locate it. S4. So here it is, S4. So if you click on S4, so you'll find, sorry, S4 editor was there. This is S matrix method. So S4, Stanford Stratified Structure Solver. You click on this, so you will find this launch tool option, and then you click on the launch tool. So you will be taken to a page, because I have opened so many others also. So here it is showing like this. Okay, I'll close view. Again, go to menu, tools. When you open it for the first time, you won't be having this problem. I have few tools open, so there is a limit to the number of sessions which you can open. That's why I had to close a session. Now again I will go to S4. So here it is, S matrix method, and then Stanford Stratified Structure Solver, and then launch tool. So if I click launch tool, then I will get the launch page. Sometimes it may ask for you to install Java, but I have already installed it here, so without any problem it will run. If not Java, maybe HTML5 also you can run. But it works with a bit of lag, and it takes some time to start, so you have to be a bit patient. Once you open it, the page, it will look something like this, and there are two methods how to run the simulation. From here you can see, use graphical interface or upload S4 input deck. Upload S4 input if you write a program and then you input it, but we won't be writing the program, we'll be using the easy way. Use graphical interface, and then you can go to parameter. So before doing this, before going into parameter, you can look here. The basic idea behind it is to simulate structured layers. Suppose for our case we purchased silicon, and on silicon we wanted to make a pyramidal structure through etching. So here for example, you can see this is one material, on top of it some other material is there, onto which a cylindrical hole has been created. So similar way, rather than defining a cylinder, we have to define a pyramid on this, a pyramidal hole on this. So I'll click on parameter. So now you will find different examples you can load, some already preset examples, some outputs are given. This you can explore later. Three major tabs are there: materials, layers and simulation. So the number of materials we have to select. Most of the time, if you are using a single layer, we can select number of materials as 2. Out of the 2 material, 1 will be vacuum, vacuum, because everything is coming from vacuum, and that way we are simulating it. One confusion is, you may say, sir, it is air, why we are simulating vacuum? But for both vacuum and air, it is, they are using it interchangeably. The parameters, the permittivity coefficients and the permeability for vacuum and air, they have used same, so no confusion should be there. And second thing, we want to simulate the silicon. So silicon is a type of dielectric, so from category I have selected dielectric, and material I will select silicon. So a bit below. Again, alphabetically it is kept, so not that difficult to find. So here I have taken crystalline silicon. Now throughout I have been saying simulating. What is meant by simulation? What basically we want to simulate the optical properties of silicon. So optical properties means the refractive index, the reflection, the reflectance values of silicon. So we'll take few cases. First we'll simulate a plain silicon, means unstructured silicon, which is the as procured silicon which we have, which you guys purchased. So what is the optical properties of that, means what are the reflectance for that plain silicon, bare silicon we call it. And then we'll try to introduce some structures on the silicon, and then we'll see how does the optical properties are changing. So first case which I'm showing you is for the bare silicon. So I've taken two materials, vacuum and silicon. Vacuum is as it is, silicon is category dielectric, and material crystalline silicon. Now I'll go to the layers. This is a bit tricky, and maybe with practice you will find it easier. But first you have to define the lattice vector. Lattice vector means the size of the unit cell which you want to simulate. So for the easy approach, we'll take it 1000 by 1000. This basically means we are simulating 1000 by 1000 square, and whatever we are defining it inside this. Okay. Now select number of layers. Number of layers for bare silicon can be 1, means on the top it is vacuum, below it is vacuum, and just we have kept a crystalline silicon in the middle. So number of layer is 1. Then further drag it down. So semi-infinite top layer is material 1. Copy the semi-infinite layer as bottom, means on the top it is material 1. You should remember material 1 is vacuum. So copy this as semi-infinite bottom. Yes, semi-infinite bottom also I have taken vacuum. I'll go to layer 1. So thickness of the layer we have to define. So if you remember the silicon wafer which you procured, around 300 microns. So 300 microns means 300,000 nanometer. So this is 300,000 nanometer. But of course material I have to change, because material 1 is vacuum. I have to make it material 2. And then number of patterns in this layer, I will explain what is meant by number of patterns. But now presently we'll go to simulation. I'll click the simulation button. So you have to be patient because sometimes it lags. So wavelength range, wavelength 300 nanometer till 1100 nanometer will run. And then I'll put simulate, and then the simulation will run. It will look something like this. It will take a bit time, not a lot of time, take maybe 10-15 seconds around. It will take, you have to wait for it, you have to let the simulation run. Some random values also may come on the screen, you don't have to bother about it. But after the simulation has run, some results you can see from here. So you can either get the output log, which will tell you what input parameters you have used and what are the control file. But mostly we are concerned with the resulting curve. So this is the resulting curve which we have obtained here. So as you can see, for bare crystalline silicon, this is the reflectance. Now our idea is we'll introduce some structures on the silicon, and then we'll try to see how the output log is changing, how the resulting curve is changing. So from here you can download this also. If you click on download, so you can either download the data or you can download the image. So image we are not that much bothered. Data you have to download. Data will be downloaded in the form of a notepad, and from that notepad you have to copy the data like this. From here you have to copy the data. This is the incidence flux. You have to copy it and paste it in an Excel file, and from there here so many columns will be there. Wavelength first, whatever wavelength we have simulated. Then we have the reflection flux, the reflectance, the red curve, the corresponding values are given here. And then we will have the transmission, means the green curve, which is mostly zero only, so hardly matters. This data you have to copy and paste in an Excel. And this reflection flux which we'll be copying, you have to take an average of the reflection flux, and that average will be the reflectance which is obtained for a bare silicon. And then you have to clear this so that the results are cleared from the memory of this simulation tool. And then you go back to parameter, then again you go back to layer.